subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to solve some examples on minimization using four variable K-map. So this is going to be the first video. In the next video, we're going to solve more examples. Being the first video for four variable K-map, we will try to understand only one example and we will try to elaborate the things in a clear way so that you can have a better understanding. So the so that to avoid the confusion with the four variable K-map, because this is going to be the bigger K-map, there may be some confusion while solving the problem. So all those confusions we will try to elaborate in this video, and the next video we will try to solve more examples. Now and the discussion about three variable K-map, examples on three variable K-map and two variable K-map has already made in our previous videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. Every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course and a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better insights of the concepts, and the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now coming to this example, it is a four variable function, and it is a sum of the product function, and these are the min terms that are there in the given boolean function. Now in order to get the K-map for the given function, the number of cells that are to be there in the K-map is 2 power n, where n is 4 variables, it is going to be 2 power 4, which is equal to 16. So there should be 16 cells in the K-map. So what is the structure of the 4 variable K-map? So the discussion about this has already been made, but in order to make the things more clear, we are again so the variables are A, B, C, D, and the values of the variables. So how many different combinations of inputs are possible with four inputs? So we have been discussed about this concept from our starting of the digital logic design course. The number of different types of inputs that are possible with four variables is 2 power 4, which is 16. See here, 16 cells are there, and the values of the variables are given here in this way: 0 1 1 1 1 0, and similarly it is 0 1 1 1 and 1 0. Now what are the decimal representations of each and every cell? Let's try to put the decimal representations of each and every cell. So it is 0, decimal representation 0. This is 0 0 0 1, which is 1, and this is 0 0 1 0 2, 0 0 1 1 3, and 0 1 0 0 4 5, 0 1 0 1 5, and this is 6 0 1 1 0, which is 6, and this is 7. And similarly, if you take here, it is going to, because we have swapped this to make this a unit distance code, adjacent rows to be the unit distance code. In order to make this, we have swapped this. So this discussion has already been made. 8 9, and this is 10, and this is 11, and here 12 13 14 15. So if you are beginner and if you are struggling with these functions, so struggling with the min terms and the conversion of the min terms into the K-map, just try to solve in this way. Try to put all the decimal conversions into this K-map, and later you try to represent all these min terms onto the K-map. That becomes very easy. So if you are beginner and if you are just started solving the K-maps, minimization by using K-maps, if it is a four variable K-map, then by representing each and every cell with its decimal equivalent will become very easy. easy to solve. So until you get practice with these representations, you try to do in this way. Now represent all these minterms onto this K-map. How that representation? We have to fill in with A because it is sum of the products. 2, 3, next is 6, 7, next is 8, 10, 11, 13 and 14. Now our next step is find the subcubes, maximum possible subcubes. So this one is going to be one subcube, and all these four are going to be one subcube, and one more combination is cheated by this two. So most of you think that this is the subcube. No, it is not. We have to find the maximum possible subcube. So the maximum possible subcube is, if you wrap around this cube, if you wrap around this K map, the maximum possibility will increase. See here, if you wrap around this, this is the biggest subcube possible. So it is possible because they are unidistant codes. And similarly, the other combination is this subcube. Wrap around. So if you wrap around like this, this is going to be the another subcube. How many subcubes are there? Okay, this is the first subcube, and consider this as a second subcube, and these two. So this one is going to be the third subcube, and this one is going to be the fourth subcube. There are how many subcubes are there? Four subcubes, and this one is another subcube. So we cannot combine it with any other one. So this is another subcube. This is the fifth subcube possible. Okay, so because how can it be a subcube? Because it is a 2 power 0, as we have said that 2 power m number of cubes, 2 power 0 is equal to 1 cell. In order to represent this 1 cell, we are using 2 power 0. So the 2 power 0, m is equal to 0 here, because there are no adjacent cells to it. Okay, so now we will try to take each and every subcube, and we will try to see what are the variables with same values and what are the variables with different values. Starting from the first subcube, so this is the first subcube. What are the variables which are same? The variables which are same is 1. This is, so it is C. It is C. And if you take this part, the variables which are same is A complement. So the first subcube is done. If you take the second subcube, the variables which are same is this one, 1, 0, which is C D complement. AB is changing throughout. So for the second subcube, the reduction is C D bar. And third subcube is this one, this one, so wrapping around. So this one becomes one single subcube. So if you take this one, it is 0, 0, 1, 0. The same one is B complement. And if you take this one, so because we are going to wrap around in this way, it is C. Okay. So the fourth subcube is this one and this one. So if you wrap around in this way, it is this one and this one. So it is going to be 1, 0. 1, 0 is going to be constant throughout, which is A B complement. And if you consider these two, if you wrap around in this way, these two are going to be adjacent. So it is going to be 0, 0, 1, 0. So the constant one is D complement. So the other variable is B complement, D complement. What is the fifth subcube that we have? This one is the fifth subcube. So the value, so it is going to be as it is, which is going to be A B C D, which is A B C complement. d. So nothing can be reduced from this 1 subcube because it is just one literal, so nothing can be reduced. So the entire term will remains the same. Are you able to get this point? Okay, so this is how we can reduce, we can minimize the given Boolean functions by using 4 variable k-maps. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding these concepts, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.